go.
Hi. We are at this place called La Marina Jamoneria. It's right by the ship in La Coruña, Spain, which is where we are. And we've heard wonderful things, but every time that we're here, it's closed. So this is the first time that it's been open. Thank goodness, because this looks amazing. And it's going to fill us up for two shows of ITD tonight. So excited about this. Oh, they also have our favorite cider, which is made in this region of Spain, that Erik is obsessed with, and they happen to have it here, which is awesome. So, cheers to...
Yeah, siesta.
My God. Very nice, formal, black onesie.
Same.
Zara. The most rare store in Spain.
So we are back at a croque-monsieur place in Cherbourg, France. And last time we came, it was a little late, and they were not serving anything besides like a basic ham and cheese. Today we got the goat cheese and the honey and the lambic beer, which is a raspberry fruit beer. Very, very tasty. apparently after Esmeralda died, he opened a cafe. Guys, so we are back in Paris and we are just exploring an area called
Le Marais.
Le Marais. Did I say it right?
Yeah.
So it's an area that is made up of like old hotels and stuff. And
it used to be like the really bougie area.
Yeah. So it's a neighborhood, yeah. Basically. And it was pretty close to Notre Dame, where we actually got to go in today. And so we decided to hit up the neighborhood while we were at it, because it was close by. And it's really pretty. And we found a little square here called the St. George Square.
Mm-hmm.
And it just has little gardens and flowers and trees and shade. And so we're just hanging out. Thought we'd check in with you guys. See you later. Dun, dun, dun. Uh-oh. Hey guys, so we are outside of the Moulin Rouge in Paris, and of course we had to come here because we love the movie, just like every other tourist that probably comes here because they love the movie. But the cool thing is that it has quite a history. It's been around for over like 130 years or so at least, and it is pretty awesome. The shows are super high quality. We watched a little video outside, and production value is like super amazing, and the tickets are so expensive. They're probably about $150 just for like the cheapest ticket. So, I mean, pretty high rollers there. But we don't have enough time, unfortunately, or the cash to see a show. But maybe someday we'll have to come back. Lots of boo-boos.
Lots of boo-boos.
That's the best. So I'm on the street where the Moulin Rouge is, and I've literally walked 10 minutes and you never guess what's down the street. And I thought it was just a few shops, but literally, it's literally every shop here, just sex shop after sex shop. They're quite liberal here in Paris. Pretty funny stuff, man. I wonder where it will end. But here's a fine establishment here. It's apparently, where you can get pole dances and lap dances and table shows. Appropriately named. All right, well, we're moving on up. It's now a love store, not a sex shop. We now have love in the equation. Da, 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 da. Ah, so this is what they were singing about in 9, I think. What's this? What's this? The There's magic in the air. What's this? So after, I don't even know how long, I don't even want to think about it. Look what I found. A Chipotle in Paris. I have to do it. I might even get two bowls. I have no idea how long I've been waiting for this. We were in Paris the last time, and I didn't know there was a Chipotle here. So this time that we made it, I had to stop. Oh my gosh. All the burrito goodness is going in my mouth.